The driver of the car involved in a high-speed fatal crash in Timaru told the first people on the scene he didn't know how he'd survived. The 19-year-old remains in hospital and hasn't been interviewed by police. Three 15-year-old boys and two 16-year-olds died in the crash. The secondary schools they have attended have spoken of their devastation. Lisa Davies reports.
Standing in the place where her young friends perished just two nights ago.
I just thought it was a big bad prank, but it's not. I wish it was.
She was closest to 15-year-old Joey McCarthy.
He had a really big heart, and he did love a lot of people. He was wonderful.
He died alongside Giovanni Drummond, also 15, the teenager's father still recovering from identifying his body.
It's going to take months and years to get over not having a son. That's the worst part. I've got two kids and one's been taken away from me.
He never thought he'd have to plan his own son's funeral.
I'm not the only one in the situation. There's 10 other parents in the same problem.
Mountain View High School has released a statement to say that sadly several of their students and ex-students were involved in the crash. They say that their staff and students are struggling to cope with this tragedy, and they're providing counsellors on site to help them deal with what's happened.
Melissa Bryce was first to arrive on the scene. She found the back end of the car first.
There was no response from that part, but behind me I heard, how the F did I survive this? And that's when I realised that there was a survivor.
The 19-year-old driver, who's still in hospital. She got him to turn the engine off before she went in to help him.
I'm shocked that someone did survive, but so was the driver himself. He was shocked that he survived it. And he's got a long road ahead of him. And I do sympathise with everyone involved in it. Even the driver, because I know that he didn't mean to make a mistake like that.
Police are yet to interview him. The investigation described as a long-term one, as the serious crash unit determines what exactly happened.
There's a variety of charges. If he is in fact held liable for the crash, I wouldn't like to even speculate what they may be.
Families like the Drummonds are focusing on their grief.
I'm really sorry to everybody that's lost a kid, even though I've lost the kid myself.
In a horrific high-speed crash that's left so many reeling. Lisa Davies, One News.